Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining. I'm Simon Floyd, Industry Director for Manufacturing at Google Cloud. Today, we will be speaking about enhancing visibility and productivity across operations. At Google Cloud, we strive to move the manufacturing industry forward, and it's always a pleasure and a privilege to work with innovative market leaders such as Phononic and SoftServe. This is why we're thrilled to work with Phononic, because together we have the opportunity to show the industry how artificial intelligence, machine learning, and data insights can drive new levels of performance. Joining me today is Jason Ruppert, Chief Operations Officer at Phononic, and Shaun, Director of IoT at SoftServe. Thank you both for joining me, and I'm looking forward to chatting with you today. To get started, Jason, would you mind telling us about Phononic and what led you to work with us?
Thank you, Simon. Phononic is the global leader in solid-state cooling and heating technology. We're revolutionizing cooling and refrigeration using unique semiconductor technology to improve the energy efficiency and reduce carbon emissions relative to the traditional incumbents of mechanical compressors. So through our technology platforms, Phononic's innovations are transforming how data is communicated, how automobiles see, how grocers merchandise and deliver food, and how vaccines and drugs are stored and protected. So at the core part of our business, we have components, thermoelectric components that move milliwatts of heat, and then we aggregate those into more heat pumping capabilities into kilowatts of heat. And those are integrated into reference designs to the types of products that I just mentioned.
Thanks very much, Jason. Shaun, over to you. It's great to chat with you again. Would you mind telling us about SoftServe and your work with Phononic?
Yeah, Simon, always nice to talk with you as well. So SoftServe focuses on high-value use cases that require integration of advanced technologies like AI, ML, robotics, edge computing, extended reality, and big data. We consult and deliver solutions with our partners like Google. As a Google Cloud Premier partner, we collaborated to help bring the manufacturing data engine to Phononic to help improve their quality control, increase their production throughput, and for remote monitoring to give them visibility across sites.
Yeah, thanks, Shaun. Jason, question for you. Could you tell us a little bit more about your overall strategy and how Google Cloud and SoftServe is helping you in this particular regard?
Well, strategy is a couple different areas. To begin, as I mentioned earlier, we're an innovation company, and we continue to innovate on our devices and systems. And as we do that, they become more complex. So our ability to connect our multi-site factory holistically. Again, we're a global operation, and capture and contextualize that data across all these discrete semiconductor and manufacturing processes. It's going to provide us the analytics and the insights to optimize our operations and continuously improve our product quality and performance. Secondly, at a discrete level, having the real-time visibility in very complex semiconductor and assembly processes is paramount. As you can well imagine, with any semiconductor process, you know, there's numerous variables that have to be completely synchronized and in alignment for a perfect operation. So our ability to harness that intelligence and act on it will not only have direct impacts on our operational performance, but also on the quality and performance of our products. And then lastly, we need to leverage AI and ML to improve our inspection capability across the entire fab and assembly processes. We want to ensure that good parts are not thrown away and that bad parts don't leave our factory.
Yeah, it really makes a lot of sense. And I would say one of the contributions that we had made from Google Cloud was putting together a solution accelerator that would help bring together all the components of our cloud and make it easy for organizations like you to get up and running quickly and to get started. We call this the manufacturing data engine, very much in the style of being able to manage those data insights and also being able to derive new ones using machine learning or artificial intelligence. Question for you both, but I'll start with Shaun. What advantages have you seen in implementing and working with the manufacturing data engine?
In working with a lot of different technology providers and a lot of different manufacturing customers, what we found is that you have to let the business and the strategy drive the technology decisions, not the other way around. But it's really important from a technology standpoint to have a base platform, and a base platform that slices the problem in the right ways so that you can extend it for the unique use cases that each manufacturer has. So with Phononic, one of the great things about the manufacturing data engine is that the components enable them to build on it, from the litmus powered in machine connect, and then the ingest and transformation of the data and through data flow and the storage in BigQuery, and then the visualizations in Looker. That's a really common platform that all the use cases that any factory is going to be working with need a lot of those common pieces to get the base part handled. But then each factory is going to need incredibly unique use cases to them. So a lot of the processes that Jason is talking about are incredibly unique to Phononic, and that is their competitive advantage. So by it being able to apply AI ML on top of that data from that platform and then deploy it to those specific processes and use cases, specifically with Vertex AI through the MDE platform, a solution accelerator, that really helps us to get the platform piece in place that all the different roles within Phononic need access to, as well as building really advanced solutions for their specific processes to help them further push their competitive advantage in the industry.
In a way, I kind of see this as almost democratization of data in the enterprise. And I hate to use a platitude like that, but I couldn't think of a better way to describe it, is bringing all those capabilities to the people that need them and making it in such a way that it's actually easy for them to use, or more conducive to incorporate into their actual work practices. Jason, you and I talked a little bit about this before, and perhaps you could give us a few more insights on what it's been like so far as sort of planning this type of solution and the type of outcomes that you hope to accomplish with it going forward.
Well, to start out again, my role as COO here is to improve the operational efficiency and profitability of the company. And, we do that by embarking on projects like this, and I would say bold initiatives, conceptualize and characterize our performance across all these discrete processes. And as Shaun was mentioning before, is being able to capture that data and act upon it. Again, our innovation, occurs across all these multiple disciplines: material science, process engineering, manufacturing assembly, metrology, and having a connected factory and using that data engine, to be able to allow us to optimize those processes in production is paramount to our success. So again, a lot of it leads to we're embracing this because we innovate quite a bit, and our products become a bit more complex, and we need that data to make sure we're operationally efficient and executing according to plan. Not only, and in addition to that, making sure that our products are better in performance and meet the highest quality standards.
Jason, I love the idea that we can help you with the agility in the business and give you the right type of platform that can kind of respond to your business needs when you need them to. And in a way, I think, I feel good about what we're providing to the industry and to you if we can serve that particular purpose. Maybe we could just dig in a little bit deeper into some of the examples you gave us. Perhaps one use case that you've seen or you have in mind where the application of artificial intelligence will really come into light, or perhaps even machine learning for that matter. Could you take us through one of those use cases, perhaps?
Sure. Our initial start on this is focused on our fab. And, we have, like, as I mentioned before, there's so many variables that have to be in complete alignment for us to produce the type of semiconductor material that's needed for high performance refrigeration systems. So being able to monitor those variables real time, and then to be able to collect that data over time and to make references as we look at product performance, not only from our components that are in or keeping networks cool and keeping cars from crashing into things from an autonomous vehicle standpoint, but also in our refrigeration products. So that's one area. The second area is getting back to AI and ML. And there's just certain things that humans, as good as we all are, it's very difficult to look at some of the nuances in some of the products or some of the components that we're looking at, both from a semiconductor and from a component standpoint. So leveraging AI and ML reduces the amount of those repetitive tasks, if you will, and allows us really, quite frankly, further insight into what we're looking at. So those are really big areas because it's, you know, a lot of the inspections sometimes are prone to a miscategorization of what a good part is and what a bad part is. And in my role in the company, I need to make sure that good parts are not thrown away because my yield is going to take a hit, or at bad parts don't make it out the factory, which is a blemish on our quality and product performance.
Yeah, thanks, Jason. Question over to you, Shaun. So how will you go about making this work for Phononic? This is a big objective. This is a huge goal to go after, to operationalize this type of technology for them. And I've got a very vast product line, as we've seen as well, many different sorts of products that we would be monitoring and manage with this type of solution. Maybe a few best practices or insights from you on how to go about this type of project.
Yeah, working with companies like Phononic, the approach that we're following with Phononic and that we found very successful is starting with standing up a platform and focusing on one use case that shows a proof of value of what we're trying to do. And so focusing on getting the data collection set up so that we can empower the engineers at Phononic to be able to look at the data and to understand the pieces of their process. And then we can build a machine learning model to help improve that process. And then we can deploy that model to show in real time how that process can be improved. And as we see the value from that system, because we then have a platform in place, now we can incrementally expand to other processes and keep showing the value and keep de-risking the cost of solving and optimizing the next process. And for companies like Phononic that have lots of different facilities and lots of different processes, they just keep getting compound interest as we add these solutions on top of each other.
Yeah, thank you very much for the insights there, Shaun. I'm sure everybody will appreciate that. It's always fascinating for me to hear from the people that are doing the real work of putting it in place. And then, of course, later on, finding out how the real work occurs when it gets into a production environment is always really exciting. Question for you both, but perhaps just back to you, Jason, to start. What are, say, 2-3 key insights that people should walk away from today after this session?
Thanks, Simon. So I'm going to talk to the operations and manufacturing executives. So, you know, as manufacturing executives and operations executives, all of our efforts and all of our actions impact three fundamental financial metrics, and that is revenue, margin, and OPEX. And you will always have pricing pressure. I don't care who you are. There is always pricing pressures. There is always competitors. So it's necessary to embark on these type of programs to remain competitive and to stay profitable. So if you think about it, of those three financial metrics, if I can improve my yield, then my margins are going to go up. If I can leverage AI and ML for a lot of redundant tasks, my operational expense is going to diminish. And if I can increase my throughput, improve the lead times to our customers, our revenue is going to increase. So it's very rare that you get all three of these financial metrics in alignment and positively impact, because typically those forces sometimes work against each other. So I call it the financial trifecta.
Thanks, Jason. I like that term as well. I'm going to use that one, financial trifecta. That's a good way to talk strategy with executives and get them thinking about their operations. I really like that one. Shaun, do you have the trifecta as well? Have you got three things that you could share with us that the audience should take away from today?
Yeah, when implementing high-tech solutions like this within manufacturing, the first piece is it's important to have a platform. A platform that has the right layers and has sliced the problem so that you can model the data appropriately, so that lots of different roles throughout lots of different places in the organization can access to that data and derive insights from it. It's important for the second point is to have AI and ML and have the AI and ML ops to deploy that at scale, so that as your team starts working with the data and understanding insights where things can be improved, you can then deploy those improvements through AIML at scale and in real time, faster than humans could respond. And lastly, to focus on moving those insights to the edge for edge computing so that you can operate with the robustness and speed necessary for manufacturing.
Thanks, Shaun. And one thing that comes to mind for me, which I think is a really great insight, is that sometimes we need to think about this technology as a method of augmenting people in the work that they do. And one of the ways that we can augment them is by doing the things that are really difficult for them to do, so that they can kind of step away maybe from the mundane or the things that are very challenging and work in other areas which would be more highly valued, if you like, rather than working on things which could be simply automated by a machine. And that's one of the things that artificial intelligence is really good at doing, is the things that are very challenging for people and automating it. And it's a great way to think about that when we're also analyzing people's operations or your own operations and thinking about where there could be a fit for artificial intelligence as an example. Well, gentlemen, it was a pleasure to speak with you both as usual. I wish we had more time. We could go on for hours and hours, but regrettably, we must close. So thank you again for spending the time to chat with me and the audience today, and in particular for sharing your insights and your experience and expertise. It really is appreciated. From all of us at Google Cloud, we're looking forward to working with you and continuing this effort forward and helping Phononic be even more innovative in the many days and many years coming forward. And we're very proud to be part of the team. So thank you, gentlemen, very much again. And thank you for our audience for joining us today.